that first knockdown came in the 10th, did you feel like you were wilting to Crawford's pressure? Because it seemed like at that point the fight was dead even.
No, I didn't. I thought that, you know, even the movement and the moving backwards, moving to the side and things of that nature, I felt like I was doing what I needed to do and what I wanted to do. I didn't feel like it was him pushing me forward or anything like that. So I thought that the fight was going accordingly.
You've literally fought everyone, and you know, look, I mean, the heartbreaking scene of you pounding that canvas at the end of the fight, there was a lot of anguish there. Do you, I mean, you've done everything. Do you think you'll be back, or could this be it for you, or what are the reasons to continue your career having fought everyone like you have?
Yeah, you know what, it's a great question, and I kind of expected that question because of fighting everyone. I'm prepared to retire. I was prepared to announce my retirement tonight. Win, lose, or draw, even if it was a draw, we had it, they were telling us we were gonna have to do it again. I was not gonna do it again. I'm announcing my retirement right now.
Great career,
Hall of Famer.
One of the guys I admire in this sport is Andre Ward. And I heard he had me up on the scorecard, so shout out to Andre Ward. One thing, I kind of hang on to every word that Dre says. I really admire him and everything that he's been to this sport. And we were in the back room about to do Tyson Fury, Deontay Wilder 3. Someone comes up to him, you know, all of the talk about Ward Canelo. And they said, come on, champ, you know you got one left in you. And he said, why can't I just have one more left in me? And the guy was confused. Meanwhile, I'm like, he said it all right there. Why do I have to continue? Why can't I just have one more in me and save it? Why can't I just have one more in me? I think a lot of times, the way that this sport is gone, you guys expect us to fight for 15, 20 years. You expect us to, you said, we hope he leaves this game with his health, but you never really know. I've been fortunate enough to be in some really big fights, get some really good guys, and always have my health at the end of the night. And, you know, with that being said, I knew that Errol Smith Jr. was gonna be my last fight. I knew that in 2017, I think it was, when he won his championship fight. And I said that he would be the last one I fought. And after we fought, I felt like there was something else, and something else was Terrence Crawford. I said, win, lose, or draw, it doesn't matter. I've given this sport a great deal, from the training to the competition, and then more training. And you know, with that being said, after you fought everybody at the top, what more do you do? I'm not going to be a gatekeeper. You would look at the four losses and would assume that, hey, well, you know, he could be a gatekeeper. Now, that's not the life that I want to live. I've never wanted to live the life of a fighter who fought into his 40s. Quiet as his kid, we wanted to fight when we wanted to end this when we was 30. We talked about that, and 34, and now's the time. 30.